Hello and welcome back to this e-learning course where we're in module 2, part 2, which is all about searching the internet. And in this little video I'm going to share with you three of what I would describe as hidden gems of internet search. We're going to have a quick look at a search engine called Instagrok. We're going to delve a bit deeper into Microsoft's Bing, and then I'm going to give you a quick tour of the Wayback Machine so that you can consider how powerful that might be in your classroom. First up then is Instagrok. Okay, so this is Instagrok, and this is another little hidden gem of a search engine. It allows you to enter a search term, for example, Great Wall of China, and then when you grok it or search it, it pulls together an interactive concept map, which includes links to websites and videos. You can scroll through the little floating box here to see some of these things, different websites, different videos, different images of what you're looking for. It also has this nice little sort of key facts box as well, which also links back to the source, so useful in terms of teaching digital literacy. Once you go into your concept map, you can explore it in a little bit more detail. So perhaps you're interested in how the Great Wall of China relates to the Emperor. And you can then start to find out other concept connections linked to that. So very, very interesting. Certainly worth exploring, a great digital literacy tool to use with your students. Hope you enjoyed Instagrok, and I think that you'll agree there's lots and lots of classroom potential there. The next website we're going to have a little look at is Microsoft Bing. In particular, we're going to be having a think about the video function and also the mapping function. So here we are on the Bing homepage. First thing to point out from an education point of view is that I can use these buttons down here to flick through the different image or the different video of the day. This is always worth having a quick look at because it provides you with some really, really good high resolution images of fascinating places around the world to discuss with your class. Let's have a quick focus on the search engine now. Let's say, for example, I search for the word rainforest. I get a number of results, not dissimilar to Google and other search engines, but the Bing video search feature is particularly good for an education point of view. Not only can I filter by length, which is always pretty handy, so perhaps I just want to find videos about the rainforest that are less than 5 minutes long, but I can also as well filter by source. So here I've now selected videos from the BBC, arguably a reliable piece of content that are less than 5 minutes long. I can now pick my videos and choose how I will use them with the class. Another hidden gem within Bing is the maps feature. If I just go to my school in Kingussie in the Scottish Highlands, I can zoom in roughly where the school is here, and I can use the features up here to switch between either different views, for example the bird's eye view, a little bit like Google Maps, or indeed the aerial view. One of the best features though, however, is the Ordnance Survey layer. And what I can do with this is I can now examine the area using a full seamless Ordnance Survey map for the whole of the UK. And I think that's one of the things that a lot of people don't realise you can use Bing for.
Well, I hope you enjoyed having a deeper dive into Microsoft Bing. The last little hidden gem we're going to have a look at is the Wayback Machine from the Internet Archive. And if you've not seen this before, I think you'll be very, very impressed, particularly with your internet safety and responsible use hat on.
Well, here we are on our last hidden gem of a search engine. This is the Internet Archive. First of all, loads and loads of copyright-free resources that you can access here. Web pages, video, software, images, and audio recordings. But we're going to have a quick look at the Wayback Machine, which is basically an archive of over 400 billion web pages that no longer exist. It's a little bit like a previous edition of a book. You know, once you overwrite a website, you've got a new edition of the book and things changes, but sometimes it's useful to go back and look at previous editions. We'll demonstrate this quickly by having a quick look at the European SchoolNet homepage. This is it here in 2015. If we however go to the Wayback Machine and put in eun.org, what it does then is it searches to see when this was last accessed. And we can see that there's actually backups of this page all the way back to 1998. If we click on 2002, we should be able to click a date where it's been connected, and then we'll see whether it can retrieve that web page. Let's see what happens. So there we are. This is the web page from back in 2002. I can scroll through the web page at the top there to see how over time how different things, you know, have changed. And it's just a kind of fascinating archive of how things used to be on the web. So a really, really, again, useful resource.
Well, I hope that you've enjoyed finding out a little bit more about my three hidden gems of search engine, Instagrok, Microsoft Bing, and also the Wayback Machine. There's lots and lots of other hidden gems out there and secret tips and tricks. Why don't you share some of these things with the other online participants? And I'll see you in the last video of the Internet Search series of Module 2. Thank you.